Hello, my name is Dara Lewis, and I work with Magna-Tech Electronic Company. I work in consulting and sales for cinema equipment. Today, I'd like to talk to you about outdoor cinemas, which would include drive-in cinemas and walk-in cinemas. Usually, the first thing I ask my client about drive-in cinemas is, what is the piece of property that you have that you want to utilize for your theater? With that information, we can determine the size of the theater, we can determine how you're going to operate, what kind of design is going to be incorporated. With a walk-in cinema, we have a little bit different take on all of that, and then we have to think about other parameters. But for right now, let's talk about drive-in cinemas. Normally, I'll ask, what is the property that you want to put this on? Is this going to be an urban area with a parking lot or some kind of a converted area that's in the middle of a city or a town? That will generate questions concerning things like light pollution, orientation of the screen, how many cars you can get in, and other various things that you'll have to think about when you're working in the limits of a city environment. But if you have a property that's in a more rural area, that perhaps you've got several acres of land that you're not doing much with, and you'd like to convert that into a drive-in, now you're going to be thinking about things like the property itself, the grading of the property, again, orientation of screen, how people are going to access your theater and the property that you're going to be putting up your cinema. Also, the size of the cinema is going to be dictated by how much property and how much land you have. You can not limit yourself to just one screen in your drive-in. You can easily put two screens up back to back, or you could have a centralized projection booth and have two projectors projecting to screens that are on either edge of your property. So there's many different ways that you can set up your outdoor or drive-in theater to accommodate your own particular environment. One of the first things that you need to think about when you're talking about your drive-in or outdoor theater is the design. Magna-Tech has the capability of helping you with all of that. Our design consultant, Arturo Quintero, is an expert in the theater business for setting up the design, the sight lines, the entrances and the exits, the lighting, the orientation of the screen, the how the cars are going to be stacked so you're not backing up traffic on a main highway, the other types of technical details that an architect or a general contractor is going to need in order to be able to assist in building your tower. The electrical loads, all of those things come into our design consultant package. We offer that along with our sale of projection equipment and sound equipment. And I would strongly recommend that no matter what, a good design is going to be the basis of a successful theater. The question being, can you make a drive-in on a parking lot? Absolutely. But you have to be aware of certain challenges that that will bring to you. Often parking lots have wheel stops, and they may not really be in a position that will allow the cars to be properly handled for your drive-in theater. You'll have to determine whether they can be removed or you can actually utilize the parking lot with those wheel stops. You also have to consider how people are getting in and out of that parking lot, where to put the ticket booth and that type of thing. Also, think about parking lots are usually very well lit at night. You usually have utility poles with fairly strong lighting. So that's another issue that you might want to take up with either the owner of the parking lot or the city in which you're planning to put your drive-in. However, having said those challenges are there, but lots of people have put up these kinds of parking lot drive-ins in various sizes, and they've been very successful at it. Drive-ins have several types of screens that you could be deciding to choose from. Many people will not be able to put in a permanent structure, and some people will only want to put in a permanent structure. So you have to make that decision, or whatever your business plan is this something that's going to be temporary, perhaps a few days, or even a few months, Or is this something that you want to be there for over, let's say, more than a few months? You'd want to put in a permanent screen. If you're doing something that's temporary, then you'll probably want to consider putting in an inflatable screen, because that gives you the flexibility of moving it to other locations. It gives you the flexibility of removing the entire screen when you're finished with the particular presentations that you're doing. But again, there are challenges with everything. Inflatable screens have to be set up and broken down every day. You don't want to leave an inflatable screen up all the time, so you have to consider the labor involved. And you also have to consider the limitations in sizes and the wind loads of these outdoor screens that are inflatable are usually only a maximum of 20 to 25 miles an hour. So if you want to do an inflatable screen, keep that in mind. If you're in a windy area or a very dusty area, things along those lines, you would probably want to think about perhaps putting in a permanent screen. Once you've come to the decision as to the size of your screen, that's when you're going to make a decision about your projection equipment. Because the size of your screen usually dictates the size or the light capability of your projector. And there are many different projectors to choose from. And also, you will need to make a decision as to whether you want to purchase laser projectors or lamp projectors. You will also need to make the decision as to whether you're going to be actually showing movies that are what we would call Hollywood content or DCI compatible. Those need to have a specific kind of projector, and I'm sure there are other people that you will talk to that will discuss all of that. But if you're showing Hollywood content, theatrical release movies, you will need to have specifically those DCI compatible projectors. We have many different choices of manufacturers and lumens capabilities, and we sit down and talk to you about your budget. We talk to you about your screen size, and we'll talk to you about the best fit for your particular business plan. Drive-ins used to have what we call the car speakers, and they were a speaker that was literally wired throughout the entire expanse of the drive-in, and the speaker was on a pole, and you would pull up next to it and put the speaker in your window. It was very expensive. And for many years, people wanted to acquire a different type of sound, and they did. They came up with radio sound systems. And nowadays, the drive-in cinemas, pretty much all of them, will utilize FM stereo sound. There are many ways that you can augment the income of a drive-in. And most theaters, of course, make their money not necessarily from ticket sales, in fact, usually never from the ticket sales. Most theaters are going to make income from concession and other services that you may offer. The concession is very important. There are various ways to approach how you're going to handle the food delivery and food ordering, and especially in these days of social distancing. There are applications available. There are companies that we work with that we can set you up with a mobile app, for example, to order food online, and then you can have it either delivered to your car, or you can pick it up at the concession stand, or you can simply go to the concession stand and order it directly. That is something you have to pay a lot of attention to, because this is how you're going to make the money in your movie theater. Cinema projectors will show regular movies that are released from the studios, but also they have the capability of showing things like an HDMI input, which you can show a Blu-ray, or you could show perhaps a camera feed, or other types of video content. So this allows you to have the flexibility to make your projection system work for you in a way other than just showing movies. So think out of the box and think of some of the things that you might be able to do on your big drive-in or outdoor screen through your projector. I can think of parties and events and graduations and weddings and ceremonies and church services and many different kinds of things. It really will be based on your knowledge of your community and what you feel your community is going to want to have in your facility. I'd like to thank you for watching this video, and I'd like to invite you to contact Magna-Tech Electronic. We're here to help. Thank you very much.